Welcome back to the Dividend Diplomat YouTube channel. You got your boys here, Lanny Burt, the Dividend Diplomat. Oh, we haven't had one of these videos in a long, long time here, Lanny. This week, we had a ton of dividend increases. So we're going to talk to you about the six big dividend increases from the last full week of October here, and how many of them we own, and how much do your passive income potentially grow this week.
Before we dive into the dividend increases for the week, smash that subscribe button. Give us a nice thumbs up, guys. We are so close right now to the 18,000 mark. Again, hopefully we've already crushed through by the time of this video, and we're on our way to 19,000 subscribers. Thanks to you guys for tuning in. But guys, just click it. Just click it. Like the video, though, too, guys. Six dividend increases, some in double digits, some in the low to mid single digits. But all great news considering the state of the economy that we're in right now.
Yeah, and why this is the main reason why we love dividend income right here, because we find and we invest in undervalued dividend growth stocks. Key on that growth, they are companies that have shown their ability to increase your dividend income and your cash flow each and every year. And why is that so important here in 2023? I don't know about you, Lanny, but did you realize we're in a high inflationary period?
We are jinkies.
I know, right? So while your purchasing power is going down, when you're not seeing your income increase in other sources, your dividend income continues to grow and help make sure that you can continue seeing the value of your dollars go up versus down.
That's what it's all about, guys, here on the dividend investing journey, the dividend investing strategy, guys. We've got six dividend increases. We're going to lay the smack it down on your dividend stock portfolios. We are increasing you and increasing your passive income by announcing these increases here, guys. This is massive here, Bert. I know you own a few names. I own a few names. Some were a few surprises for
yes,
sure.
Yes, they were.
Man, I'm pumped.
Yeah, this first company, I know I don't own them. You don't own them. The Flying V, that's right. We're talking about Visa. Ticker symbol, V was number one. This one was a great one to start the week off here, Lanny, because you definitely saw your passive income grow. What was that dividend increase?
Another double-digit banger from the Flying V. Visa Inc. continues to tear the cover off the ball, 15.56%. Still yield below 1%, but that means my yield is flying high, though, because of my yield on cost. 14 years of dividend increases, and I'm proud to say I think I've been almost, I've been a part of every single one.
Ducks fly together. That's the beauty of it. And you don't buy Visa because of the high yield. You buy them for the yield and the growth. So if you have a low yield, you expect a high dividend growth. That's what you want to see. If you have higher yield, you're not expecting it. You're expecting lower dividend growth. So Visa delivered. So sure, they may have a 1% yield, but they just juice your income almost 16%, Lanny, because that's what it's all about.
Exactly, guys. Man, wow.
Yeah.
Love it, love it, love it. But that second increase, which is very will be a consistent theme within the industry, Bert. But what was the second dividend increase announcement we saw this week?
Marathon, ticker symbol MPC. All right, so Marathon's always the funny one, because aren't there two Marathons, Lanny? I think that they're two different marathon companies. They have a really weird structure, but it doesn't matter. They are the big oil and they're the big gas company. And sure, look at the gas pump. Look at the gas pump. Oil price of barrel continues to surge. Price of gas goes up. So what happens during that time? This is when the oil companies continue to rake in money. They see their highest periods of cash flow. You're seeing some of the big ones, Exxon and Chevron, make huge acquisition announcements. This is the time for them to make moves with their money. And that's what Marathon did. They announced
moved with that money.
Yeah, they didn't announce an acquisition. They announced a huge dividend increase. They announced a 10% dividend increase, juicing up that quarterly dividend from 75 cents to 82.5 cents. Beautiful, beautiful increase for Marathon.
So MPC is the petroleum corp based here in Ohio, actually.
Western Ohio.
Which, you know, the other, so that was MPC, and then there's MRO, which is Marathon Oil.
Yes, and it's always
in Houston.
Yes, and it's just always confusing. So we at least know the Ohio-based one, because Ohio proud, Ohio strong. That's what it's about, O-H-I-O. Juiced up that dividend there. So their yield, they're never the highest. Marathon is not the highest oil yielding oil company. And that's always something important to remember. Both Marathons yield in the 2% range. So MPC's yield is 2.23%, even with the increase.
Man, awesome. But let's get into that third dividend increase. The healthcare pharmaceutical that I think everybody owns in their portfolio. Bird owns it. I own it. AbbVie, ticker symbol ABBV. And I think this increase came a little early this year. I think they're a typical November
Yeah, I was
increase.
getting ready. I was doing research for my November article, the November dividend increase article. We always put every month on the blog. All the increases are coming up. I had to delete them out of the draft of the article and out of my research because they announced early at the end of October, they increased that quarterly dividend from $1.48 to $1.55, 4.7% increase. But they also got crushed with earnings. So their yield is now soaring well above 4%. Again, their yield is over 4.25% for AbbVie.
Wow, already back up there, guys. Again, a nice 4.7% increase, fairly consistent with the last raise that they had last year. We'll always take an increase when it comes early. That's cool with us. We love getting the dividend news earlier than later.
That's right. And they've increased every year since the big Abbott AbbVie split off to spin off. So I know Abbott has a very long historic history, so it transfers over, but it doesn't actually show it on the ticker. Management always increases Abbott's dividend. That's what you all need to know.
Boom. There it is, guys. Going into that stock number four. Number, do you own this stock?
Yes, I do. You own this
Nice.
stock too, right?
We own the stock in my wife's account, Bert. So we just talked about Marathon. Let's go over to another. Is this the one of the bigger oil companies in the game?
They are one of the biggest ones. They are, in fact, aren't they the biggest?
Let's see my market cap at least, even though
Yeah.
I'm preparing right now.
Yeah. All right. Well, I'll release it while you're doing the research here. ExxonMobil, ticker symbol XOM. I see you nodding, Lanny. So does that mean they are the largest market cap oil company?
Oh, it's true. It's damn true.
Yeah, so I teased it. They already announced a big acquisition here. So that's one of the things, but I think it's always funny. They must be flowing. The oil in the black gold must be flowing into their cash flow statement because not only did they announce an acquisition, they announced a dividend increase as well. They increased that quarterly dividend from 91 cents to 95 cents. That's a 4.4% increase for ExxonMobil.
We'll take it. We'll take it. Let's get into that dividend stock number five. Another surprise here of an increase. Why? Because they're supposed to be getting acquired. We love it when a company should be acquired at some future point, but yet they're saying, cool, cool story, bro. We're still going to raise our dividend for our current shareholders. And that's just what Westrock, ticker symbol WRK, did. They played their theme music and came out with a 10% dividend increase from 27.5 cents to 30.25 cents per share.
Beautiful. Yeah, it is hilarious. That's why you and I were both so shocked about that. Figure when they're getting acquired, the cash flows stay the same. You have to get two management teams approving a dividend increase, not just one. The acquirer needs to sign off on that too. It's great. I have nothing more to say. It's fantastic. They cut their dividend at the beginning of the pandemic to preserve that balance sheet, and now they've increased it for 3+ years after that initial dividend cut. So I don't think there are too many of WestRock investors that follow our channel. I don't think there are too many WestRock investors out there. But the two of us are. So congrats to us for getting a 10% dividend increase right there
Cheers,
from
bro.
Westrock.
Cheers.
That's right. And then
And
we'll.
they still aren't back to their pre-pandemic dividend.
Nope, just ignoring it, Lanny. I don't want to hear it. We're going on positive vibes with 3+ dividend increases.
All right, bro, we'll wrap it up here with the sixth dividend increase that we want to talk about this week because I know you've owned it for quite some time.
AEP, ticker symbol A. E P. You know I love when tickers are the same as the company's name. They are the big electric utility company out of Columbus, Ohio. Massive, massive utility. Another Buckeye State company increasing its dividend. This one was fun. I didn't catch it. It's always fun when you text me and say, "Well, check this out," and then it's a dividend increase for a company I own. 83 cents was their previous quarterly dividend. Now it is 88 cents. That's 6% dividend increase. Yields up to 4.74%. They've increased for 13+ years. They are right on target with their average increase.
Solid, just sound and solid AEP, just killing it in Columbus, killing it in Ohio. Good job. Congrats, Bert, to you on
Thanks.
that. Congrats to all the AEP shareholders.
Yeah.
But that was the six increases we wanted to talk about, guys. Bert, you want to rip? I'll rip off the first three, and then you can finish off with the back three. Visa 15.6%. Marathon Petroleum, MPC, at 10%. AbbVie, ABBV, at 4.7%.
Beautiful. ExxonMobil, 4.4%. Westrock at 10%. And then round it out with AEP at 6%. Lanny, from this list, I'll go through it first. I own AbbVie, Exxon, Westrock, and AEP. I started off slow, but then I finished strong. What about you?
I own Visa, AbbVie, Exxon, Westrock. I also have four out of six.
All right, everyone. So let us know how many of the six you own down there. Did you beat us? Did anyone have five or six? Let us know down there. And also, we can't catch every dividend increase in there. Let us know if you received an increase that was not featured in this video today.
Let us know, guys. Definitely subscribe. Like the video. Let us know what else you're buying out there in the stock market. I know this is an increase video, but let us know what stocks you're buying as well. Let's keep reaching financial freedom. And Bert, there's one more thing you got to tell the community, Jack.
If you're not with us, you're against us. So get out of here.
Oh, that was Bert and Lanny from the Dividend Diplomats, over and out.